Hello everyone, this is Inayat Mir with my CompTIA A plus 900 series first presentation, which is called L1 or Lecture 1. Please watch intro video where I have explained all about the benefits of watching this website for the download, and also I talked about a link for a Dropbox, because you have not in megabytes, in approximately in gigabytes data to get into your own home computer for practice, and you will have a lot of exam questions, exam practice, and you will have a lot of demos, and also you will have over 40 hands-on labs, virtual labs, which you are going to perform at your own Windows 8 or 8.1 or on Windows 10 computer. So those labs are compatible with any operating system which is a client or which could be a server operating system. So let's talk about CompTIA 900 series 220-901 and 220-902 exams. So I'm going to give you a brief lecture on these all slides. So I have prepared about 25 lectures for this whole exam, and one finalized lecture. That lecture will give you overview about exam, and a very basic lecture will also provide you information about the exam and about the way I am delivering my lecture, and about the way you can get the benefit from my website, where you can download a lot of videos and a lot of documents. Plus, you also can use an additional backup email, so where you will see all of the links. Plus, you also will get a Dropbox link where you can go and download data, videos, and whatever is important actually for your exam and for your class from a Dropbox. You also can see a support number. Plus, for very new users, if you want to set up a schedule like a live online training, so we also discussed in the intro video, and you will see that all information there. So let's start from lecture number one. So we're gonna see a couple of infos here on the slides, and we will take a look on those slides, and we will discuss a look at a desktop computer, overview about storage devices, overview of connections and interfaces, printers and speakers. So these are different four things what I am talking about right now. So we're gonna give you this all through slides, and at the end of these lectures or end of these slides, I might go into my real life network, and also I can bring in remotely that network and show you how this all looks and how this all works. First, very basic, common computer components. So you see that everyone has a desktop or a laptop. You might have some PDAs or some devices which are like remote devices, an iPad, whatever. Currently we will focus on a desktop computer or and laptops, because A plus CompTIA objective covers this all in the exam, and I will also provide you exam objectives in the Dropbox link, and I will try to post on the website, and I'm not sure I did it yet or not, but you will see under notes and videos pages a link, or really you will see exam objectives for both exams. So everyone has a computer, everyone knows that they have a desktop or a laptop. So what you see currently here, this is a system unit. Inside of this unit you have your motherboard, then you have your CPU, central processing unit, your memory, RAM, RAM, random access memory, your internal storage devices, and your IDE controller, your SATA controllers. IDE is an integrated device electronic. SATA is a S as in Sam, A as in Apple, T as in Tom, A as in Apple. Serial ATA devices and their controllers. and a lot of more information which we will go and cover, but that resides under your system unit. Okay, this is a kind of a PC box, and then behind that you have a video card, could be built in and could be on a expansion card. It depends what type of computer you have. So that is linked with this display device, which is a monitor where you can see the output from your back of your computer's video port to the display device. If you disconnect that cable from your video connector, you won't be able to see anything on this screen. Then you definitely have this mouse connected at this time behind these computers. Could be wireless, but for desktops we prefer to have it as a USB, universal serial bus, same thing as a keyboard. Then you might need speakers. Could be external, could be integrated with display device, or you can use within your system unit a sound card. But that sound card, if you have in the system unit, you might need to have a headphone so you can hear that, or you might need to have your speakers so you can connect behind that system unit. Then of course we all need a printer, so we do have a printer here in this image. This is an external device, and most likely people use wireless printers these days, but yes, you can use a USB. In the past we were using IEEE 1284 compatible printers with a printer cable attached directly behind the system unit, but it is still the same. But the only difference is that now we have a wireless, or we have attached into the system unit. So that was one thing which I was going to discuss. Inside of the system unit you will see a motherboard. On the motherboard you will see a CPU. This is a CPU fan over the heatsink. This is your chipset. These are your AGP, accelerated graphic port, for video card slot. These are the PCI slots, and this is your chips. This is a main chipset. This is your another chip. You will see about. We will discuss about a north bridge and the south bridge. This is your memory, and this is your main power supply, 20 connectors. This could be 20 or could be 24. And this is your IDE controller, secondary and primary for hard drives. It is a kind of little bit old concept, but we still use them. This is your floppy, which we may not be using at this moment. 34 pin floppy, 4040 pin IDE controllers, and this is your BIOS battery. So these are a few things I showed you on the motherboard slide. And this is a screenshot of my physical desktop computer. So what I'm showing you here, currently it is showing you here 56 gigabyte memory, and this is a processor, Intel Core i7 processor, 3.7 gigahertz speed on the CPU. This is the memory and RAM, 64 bit operating system, and this is my computer name, H as in Henry, H, V as in Victor, M-A-I-N, H-V main. This is my host name. Then description is a physical server, because this is a server operating system I'm running on my physical box, because on top of it I have virtual machines using a Hyper-V. I'm using virtual machines, and that is why I'm showing you this one. So before we pack up this presentation, let me show you exactly where that server is. So let me go remotely and I will come back and show you a demo on that server where you can see the system properties and where you can see your physical server. Then later when we talk about virtual machines, and I will talk about virtual environment. So let's go and take a look on the physical server. Alright, so this is my remote machine where I am looking at this time my virtual server and a virtual client. So let's I don't have to show you the virtual environment yet, but the server I was showing you was this server. You go to the computer and right click from start computer, right click and go to properties, and you will see here the system information. It is the same server which I took a screenshot in my presentation. So here same thing, only the difference between this and my presentation is memory. So I had a 56 gigabyte memory before, now I have a 64 gigabyte because I added up some more because I'm running on virtual machine. This is my virtual server, virtual client, so because of that one. So this was just to show you how I was planning to do this all work, and I have to show you a lot of things in my own network where you will see some other virtual environments which I'm going to click on here. I got some different setup for multiple projects, for my Active Directory Federation services project, my certificate services project, my learning management system project. So these all things are virtual, these are servers are virtual are running on top of this physical computers as EMIR physical server. So that is where I will discuss with you, and we will talk this all about in future videos. So we got a lot of more videos to come where I will explain a lot of things, plus you also gonna see a lot of live demos, and I will let you do as a simulated environment, and you will do practice at your home as well the way it's supposed to be. So you gain, or you should gain, a lot of hands-on knowledge to pass this very important exam. So I am back into my screen where I was before, and I went into my virtual environment, pulled out that screen. Now you remember that what I was trying to show you. On the top you see multiple CPUs or central processing units. So these are all what you see right now from the first, and the second one looks like that it was actually shown to you kind of a fan on my motherboard picture in the previous one. So CPU could be a slot CPU or could be a socket CPU. So you will talk about this one, and we will discuss about this all info in future videos. So just keep an eye on my all lectures, and also try to read all slides which I have posted on my website. You will see 15 chapters with all details. So let's talk in my next video for all about this. So I will see you in my next lecture. Thank you for watching this lecture.